Students, very good morning. Yes, how are you all? Are you all keeping fine? Good, very good. Okay, so students, have you started class? As in the previous class, we were discussing about chapter 4. Isn't it? You are discussing about chapter 4, water, a wonderful liquid. What did we discuss in that class? We discussed about the water. Water has three forms: solid, liquid, and gases, isn't it? Then, first topic we discussed that the some materials are soluble in water, isn't it? So we will move further in the chapter, in the same chapter, the chapter 4, a wonderful liquid. Okay. So, please open the book at page number 15. All of you, open the book at page number 15, chapter 4. Chapter 4, a wonderful liquid. Water, a wonderful liquid. Water, a wonderful liquid. This is the chapter. Okay? Already we have started yesterday, isn't it? So today we will move further. Okay. So we understood, we did some experiments about topic 1. Some materials are soluble in water, that we did experiment on. Okay. So today we will discuss about the second. First, let us know a little about the gases in water. Gases in water. Do you think gases are available in water? What do you think? Is gases available in the water? Yes, it is available. That is why the plants and animals which they live in the water, into the sea, into the river, they need gas, they need oxygen to survive, isn't it? As we need human beings and animals or plants, they need the gases to survive. We human beings need the oxygen, isn't it? Then plants, they need carbon dioxide, isn't it? Carbon dioxide to survive, to make their food in the presence of sunlight, isn't it? So same way, the living beings, they live in the water. They also need the gas, isn't it? So for them, from where do they get the gas? They get the gas from water itself, isn't it? So we can say, or it is proved that the gases are available in water. Okay, gases are available in water. Maybe in the next chapter we will do the experiment that how the plants in the sea or in the water, how they take the oxygen, how they take the gases in the water, and how they release the gas in the water. So that we may discuss in the next chapter, because this is next chapter is for plants and animals in waters. Okay, there we will discuss more about that. But here we are just discussing about gases in water. So gases are available in the water. Okay, gases are available in water, like fish. They need oxygen to survive in the water. So they take the oxygen from water. Isn't it? That also we will discuss in the next chapter. So gases like oxygen and carbon dioxide dissolve in water. Yes, they dissolve in water. In soda water or in any soft drinks, carbon dioxide is dissolved under pressure. Carbon dioxide is dissolved under pressure. When we open a bottle of soda water, we see the dissolved carbon dioxide escaping out rapidly in the form of bubbles. In the form of bubbles, when you sink yourself into the water, just you blow, then what you will see? The bubbles coming out from water. So that is there, that dissolves the oxygen or carbon dioxide, that dissolves in the water. Okay, so understood? Are gases available in the water? Yes, gases are available in the water. Okay, then second topic or second point today we discuss, and that is some materials sink and some float in water. Some materials sink and some float in water, and some float in water. Some materials sink and some materials float in water. Okay, is it visible? The board is visible for everyone? Okay, very good. Then see the paragraph. First you read the paragraph, then we will go for the experiment. Okay, first we will read this this topic in the paragraph, then we will go for the experiment. Okay, we will do the experiment also. So let us start. Some materials sink and some float in water. Take a beaker. You take a beaker, or you can take a glass, you can take a jug, whatever you have available at home. Okay, whatever you have, you take it. Okay. But when we go to the science lab, the things are available there, like beakers, then like glass tumbler, then like what are the things? Test tube, all those things are available in the lab, in the science lab. But when we are staying at home, we have at home the glasses, the jug, whatever. Okay, they are there. So just we will read the paragraph, then we will go for the experiments. Take a beaker and fill about 2/3 of it with water. Drop an iron nail in it. If you have iron nail, well and good. Or you don't have, you can take the stones. The iron nail sink in the water and settle down at the bottom of the beaker. Only those things sink in the water that are heavier than water. Remember, only those things sink. Those things say that are heavier than water. So we say that iron is heavier than water. Okay. Now take another beaker and fill about 2/3 of it with water. Drop a small pieces of wood in this water. The piece of wood does not sink in water. The material that floats in water is lighter than water. Okay, so wood is lighter than water. Substances heavier than water, iron, copper, aluminium, stone, and chalk are heavier than water. Substance lighter than water, wood, plastic, ice, oil, and kerosene are lighter than water. So this is about some materials sink and some float in water. Come back to our
chapter. Okay, or again we will come to the topic. Yes, so students, shall we start the experiment? Very good. Okay, are you ready? Good. Let us start the experiment. See, this is jug. I have taken water in the jug because I have the availability here, that is jug. I have glass also, but glass is little small, but the jug is little bigger than that. Okay, so I have taken a jug. I have filled half water in the jug. Now what I have to do, I have to drop a heavier, the material which is heavier than water. Like in the book it is, like book we have read about an iron, isn't it? But here I have taken a stone. I have taken a stone. Okay, what I have to do? I have to just drop the stone into the jug. See, I am dropping the stone into the jug. What do you see? What do you see? Yes, we see the stone has gone inside the water and that is remaining under the into the water at the surface of jug, isn't it? You can see the water is here and the stone is into the water there below. Okay, so this is first. So this shows that the stone is heavier than water. This proves that stone is heavier than water. That is why it sinks into the water. Okay, next step, and that is we will take a wood. We'll take a wood, small piece of wood I have brought a small piece of wood. Can you see? Yes, you can see it. You can see it. Very good. So what I have to do? I have to, if you want to remove this water, you can remove it or you can throw it. Otherwise, just take another jug and fill the water same level, or you can take the stone out or nails out and keep it away. Okay, now it is clean, the water is clean, you can see it very properly, isn't it? So what you have to do? You have to put the piece of wood in the water. So just I am taking this piece of wood and I will drop it into the jug. Just you see, I have dropped into the jug. Do you see the wood is floating on the water? Is it sunk? When you will press it, it will go down, but when you leave, again it will come out. Why? This is because of the weight. So this wood is lighter than water. This wood is lighter than water, isn't it? Wood. So these two experiments we have done. Now you understand why some materials sink in the water and some materials float in water. The so substance, what the substance is? Substance, this substances heavier than water, they sink into the water. Water are the things that are heavier, or that are heavier than water. We have already read, they are iron, copper, aluminium, stone, and chalk also. Chalk also are heavier than water. See, they sink also, and some chalks, if they are heavier than water, they will sink, or which is lighter than water, they will come float. They will not sink. Okay, so this experiment we have done, isn't it? So we'll come back to our class again, then we will discuss more about this.
So students, have you seen the experiment which we have done now? Just 1 minute before, or 1 second before, half minute before. Okay, so this is why it happens. It happens because the material, those float on the water, they are lighter than water, and the materials, those sink in the water, they are heavier than water. Okay, so as we are discussing, substance heavier than water, I already told you iron, aluminium, then copper, stone, they are sinking into the water and they are heavier than water. Okay, then substances lighter than water. What are the things? We did the experiment first one, that is wood. Then second, plastic. You take the plastic and put into the water and you will see that will not sink, that will float. Then ice, you know, the ice, yesterday we were talking about the solid form of water, ice. You take the ice and you drop it into the water, into the jug. Fill the water, fill the jug, half of the jug, then drop the ice cube and you will see that ice is floating on the water because it is lighter than water. Then oil and kerosene oil also, when you will put the oil on the water, that will also, what that will do, that will float. Okay, because it is lighter than water. So we understood some materials sink and some materials float in water. So understood all of you? Yes. If you are finding difficult to understand, do one more practical at your home so that will be clear to you. Okay. Now you have lot of times when you are staying at home, you do the practical and see by yourself. Okay. Not I am not telling or the book is telling you. Sometimes I can also make mistakes. Sometimes in the book also some mistakes can be there. But when you do the experiment of your own, you will understand that whether the book is right or not. So don't believe blindly. You try to find out what is the truth. Suppose if we in the mathematics, what you see in the math, 2 + 2 is equal to 4. I say, and you don't believe just what I am saying. You do it. What 2 + 2 is exactly? Is it equal to 4? 2 + 2 is equal to 4. Is it correct or not? You also have to do. You also have to find out. That is the law of wisdom. When you are student, when you are studying, you should love the wisdom and find out whether the things are, is it written in the book correct? Is it the sir is telling us that is correct or that is what the sir is telling, is it correct? You have to find out. You also do the practical. You also do the experiment. Find out the things are, is it right or no? Okay. So that curiosity should be there. That curiosity should be there in your mind, in all students. Okay. So take it very seriously. Take the studies very seriously because that will be help you in the further. When you will go to in the higher classes and like class 10, 9, 10, 11, 12, there you will have more experiments in the labs about science, in the science lab. Okay. So at that time also you participate in all kinds of experiments so that the things will be clear to you. Okay. So let us not take too much time. We will go to the third point, and that is properties of liquids. Properties of liquid. It is in a book, don't stick here and there. Okay. Just I am writing here to make you aware. Properties of liquids. Properties of liquid. What do you understand by property? Property that I have car, I have house. Yes, of course, that is also your property. Isn't it? Okay. So here we are speaking about the liquid, properties of liquid. We are speaking about properties of liquid. You see this, liquids. What is the properties of liquids? I am not asking about your property, that you have car, you have bag, you have house, you have many things. I am not asking about that property. But here I am speaking about the properties of liquids. Properties of liquids. Send it. So see the book. Once we will read, then we will go for the experiment if it is possible. Okay. Shall we start? Yes. Let's now take a look at the properties of liquids. You know water is a kind of liquid, so let us examine that wonderful water. Let us examine this wonderful water as the topic is water a wonderful liquid. Water a wonderful liquid, our topic is water a wonderful liquid. So here we will discuss about, examine about this wonderful liquid. Okay. Now first point, take some water in a beaker and mark the level of water in it. Take some water in a beaker and mark the level of water in it. Take water. The water takes the shape of the beaker. Pour the water from the beaker into a glass tumbler. The water takes the shape of the glass tumbler. Now put the water into a float bottom flask. The water takes the shape of a flat bottom flask. This experiment shows that water or liquid has no fixed shape. No fixed shape of its own. It takes the shape of container into which it is put. It takes the shape of container in which it is put. Okay, we will go for the experiment. Yes, let us continue our experiment. Okay, what we are discussing? We are discussing about the properties of liquid. Okay, properties of liquid. You will see in the first, in the jug, you will see that water level is here half. The water is in the shape of jug. Water which is into the this jug, that is in the shape of jug, isn't it? And we can mark it. This is half. This is half of the jug the water is. But when we pour it into the glass, see, I just am pouring the glass. The water is taking the shape of glass. Now I have poured the water into the glass. So this water has taken the shape of glass. In the previous, the water was in the shape of jug. I had marked it that water was half, but now I have poured the water into the jug. Now the water is full. It is little bit not up to the level, but now the water has taken the shape of jug. Okay, then we will move next. I am going to pour a water into the bowl. This is a small bowl. See, I am pouring the water into the bowl. The water is taking the shape of bowl, isn't it? The water is taking the shape of bowl. You can see this water has taken the shape of bowl. Bowl, isn't it? So this is the properties of liquids or properties of water we have just read in the chapter. This happens why? Because the liquid has not fixed shape. The solid form of water, that is in the form of ice. Ice are in the shape. When you will fill the water into the or ice, you can see that can be kept in the shape, isn't it? But liquid has no shape of its own. Liquid has no shape on it of its own. It takes the shape of the container into which it is put. So different shape you will see. The water that is in the jug, that is in different shape. The water in the glass, that is in different shape. You can see the level of water, isn't it? That is different, isn't it?
then you are seeing here bowl, the steel bowl. So here also the water shape is different. So water changes the shape of it, isn't it? So this is the properties of water we have understood. Okay, then we will move next, or the next line, what the it says about water.
Yes, now first we have discussed and we have did the experiment also. Now second, at page number 70, what is it? Now pour the water from the flood bottom flask back into the original beaker. We find that water fills the beaker up to the same mark. Okay, up to the same mark. Didn't have the mark also. We didn't mark it, but we can arrange it. Okay, so same mark. So we conclude that water has a fixed volume and that this volume does not change even when the container is changed. So water has the same volume even when the container is changed. So water liquid has a fixed volume. Okay, just to that remember, we can do the experiment also. Liquids have the following properties. First, it has no fixed shape. First property, that is, it has no fixed shape. Okay, it takes the shape of the container in which it is poured. As we have done the experiment, it takes the shape of the container in which you will pour. Okay, first property. Second, it has a fixed volume. Okay, you remember. It is not hard. Water is soft. It flows from a higher level to a lower level. Okay, higher level, that means when you pour the water from high, that will flow to the lower. It will not go from lower to high. Okay, it doesn't go from lower to high, but when you pour the water, that will flow from higher to lower level. So four properties, remember, okay, remember these four properties we have discussed. First, we have done the experiment also. It has no fixed shape. It takes